Amy Stone Circles, the guy gave me a ring, someone from there gave it to him, and they were all runes, just like this silver band it was. White ones are nice as well. They need to do labels. All these pythons, right, they're being saved from people's coppers, find them abandoned, right, and misused, and they end up here.
he argues, depends on me.
No, he's an arguing for you. You're working it out now, are you? No, you've been taught. Now they've gone, what's wrong with his chops? Oh, they're a bit wonky, isn't he? He's a beautiful creature, isn't he, that one? Looks like moss chops off a star. Same old thing, though. The thing is, that one's not made of fire. That one's made of flesh and blood. You missing an eye, lad? Oh, bug, I know when he's like that. No, he's not. It's just us. There we go. 5 minutes is a score, you better get going, is it?
Chunky up here, that's where the muscles are, a bit of a fat store as well. And it's nice and flat down here. Where it's flat in profile, it's the highest part of the tail, perfect shape for swimming, that's what it's for. Also with regards to the water's surface element, have a look at the size of his jaws. You see all these tiny little black dots, like little stubble. Each one of these little dots is a sense organ. Each one is more sensitive than your fingertips. And where are they concentrated? What a surprise. Right at the water's surface when he is in difficult croc mode. So any splashes, anything entering the water or moving across the surface, this guy's onto it immediately. Very much tuned in to the water's surface. Water's edge, water's surface. That keeps you safe too if you're on holidays in Australia or Africa or America, somewhere where there's crocs or alligators, just always.
Show off Hugo over to his body, sitting there gaping nicely at that enclosure. Maybe I've ever seen those jaws shut with something like the approaching chunk of the square inch of our biggest jaws. The really big crocodiles are about 2 meters longer than Hugo. They can see their jaws. Thank you. crocodiles, generally speaking, the water's in the water surface predators. They're out in the water, they come out and grab a hold of something. The crocodile themselves are coming out of the water, ground level. That's very weak position to be quite away from the hour or another animal. That tremendous bite strength gives them a possibility to choose to shock the animal prey that they're grabbing in the water. If there is any resistance, they may not let them go, so they just do that roll, famous crocodile roll, and then I'll let them go, and whatever they're holding, there's no choice of the old balance. Okay, so that bite strength, very important for crocodiles to be able to get their head in. There's also a bit of a mini tug of war that goes on sometimes when they're feeding. That is always tend to attach on to these stomachs. It's hard for us to convey how strong or tightly we have to hold on to these tongs sometimes. Because they're starting to, as the weather warms up, they start to jump a little higher, so we are starting to have to use our peripherals to make sure that while we're holding these tongs out over the water, then the other ones not jumping up. They're not too fussy, whichever the tongs are going for. We would prefer them to go to this end, so we'll just have to keep our eye on things. So today I'm feeding them a bit of buffalo as a bit of meat. You don't always feed them just bits of meat. Ordinarily, we're giving them the whole body of prey, whether that is a rat, an ounce, chicks, quails, things like that.
That's a rough rat, isn't he?
Just
four, Scott.
Yes, I brought around about 14 or 15 pieces of food for these crocs. If your maths is any good, you can tell it.
He's hungry.
The only thing you can do is for your comparison, if you had a pet crocodile and it weighed the same as you did, in one day you'd be more food than that crocodile requires in a week. So the only one you come up